Bhagavad Gita, 8th chapter, Arjuna Uvacha. Arjun said, Kim tad brahmat kimad yatmam kim karma purushottama adhibhutam chakim proktam adhidaivam kimuchyate. Purushottama, best among purushas, among men. Tat, that brahma, brahman, kim, what, adhyatmam, adhyatma, kim, what, karma, karma, and kim, what, adhibhutam, adhibhuta, kim, what, proktam, called, kim, what, cha, and adhidaivam, adhidaiva, uchyate, is said. Arjuna is asking Sri Krishna, what is Brahman? What is Adhyatma? What is Karma? What is called Adhibhuta and what is Adhidaiva? All the definitions he is asking. Further he asks, Adhiyajnyah katham kotra dehesmin madhusudana prayana kalecha katham nyeyosi niyatatma bihi. Madhusudana, the destroyer of Madhu. So, the destroyer of the demon Asura, Madhu. Atra here, asmin in this dehe body. Kaha, who, katham, how. Adhi yagnya, cha, and prayana kale, at the time of death. Niyata atma bihi. Niyata means controlled. Atma bihi, self. So, by the self-controlled, katham, how, nyeyaha, knowable, asi, are. The question, the second question is, first question is, what is Brahman, what is Adhyatma, what is Adhibhuta, what is Karma, and what is Adhidaiva? Second question is, who and in what way is Adhiyajna happening in this body? Also, how are you known at the time of the death by the self-controlled? So Arjuna accepts that one needs to have self-control. First, one needs to do the activities of self-control. But even after that, how is one known by you? One knows you. How are you known by someone who is self-controlled? So though a person might undergo self-control as part of spiritual practice, how will that person know you at the end of one's life? Sri Bhagavan Uvacha, Lord said, Sri Krishna said, Aksharam Brahma Paramam Swabhavah Adhyatma Muchyate Bhuta Bhavod Bhavakaro Visargah Karma Sanyitah. So now he is answering these questions. Aksharam, that which is not kshara, that means that which is not destroyed, that which cannot be ended, that which does not perish. Aksharam, imperishable. Paramam, supreme. Brahma, Brahman. Swabhavah, nature. The nature of Brahman, that it is present everywhere. Adhyatmam, adhyatma uchyate, is said. Bhuta bhava udbhava karaha, that which causes karaha, that which causes the bhava existence, and bhuta existence and bhava, and the genesis of beings, which causes the existence and genesis or the birth of beings. Visargaha, offering, karma sangitaha, is called karma. So what is Brahman? The imperishable is supreme Brahman. Brahman is that which cannot be destroyed. That which does not destroy, that which does not get, that which does not perish, is Brahman. And also, so first question was, what is Brahman? Next question was, what is Adhyatma? Adhyatma is that this Brahman is there in each body. It's Adhyatma. That is, Atma means self, individual self. Adhi means basis. So the basis of individual self, that means the basis of everything, every person, every individual being, that is Adhyatma. So how does Brahman become the basis of every individual being? Because that is what is going to remain. So that is Brahman. So that is why it is Adhyatma. Uchyate, it is said. And also, Bhuta Bhavod Bhavakaraha. It is the Visargaha offering. It is the offering to gods, which causes the birth and the support of all living beings. So, what does it mean? It means that you are doing something, and because of that, you are born. It is because of your karma, it is because of the results of your action that you are born. So this doing something is like offering to gods. You are offering your actions to gods, and because of that, you are born. If you did not have any desire, then you will not be born. So this your offering of things to gods, this your having desire causes birth and causes the sustenance also. So it is the genesis, it causes the genesis, and it also causes the sustenance. Why sustenance? Because you continue to do actions with the idea that you are the doer and you are the experiencer. So those actions bring about good and bad experiences. They bring about good and bad births. So this is a repeated phenomenon. It goes on and on and on. That is what is told here. So that visarga, that is that offering which is done to gods, which creates the existence or the birth and existence of living beings, that is called karma sanghita, that is called karma. First, what is Brahman? That which does not perish is Brahman. Then, what is Adhyatma? The fact that this Brahman is in every individual self, every individual being, that nature is Adhyatma. And what is karma? Karma is the offering of this individual body to gods, which to gods means actually because of desire you do something and you offer it to gods. So that is the cause of birth and life, birth and sustenance of all living beings. That is called karma. So three questions he has answered. What is Brahma? What is Adhyatma? And what is karma? Yes. No, not whatever you do as an offering to God. Whatever you do for the sake of attaining some desire. Not as an offering to God, but you offer something to God for getting something. For example, there are kamya karmas in Vedas. In the Vedas, in the scriptures, rituals are given which you do to attain some particular thing. That when you do, that is called karma, that karma. So here it should be compared with what is told in the third chapter, 14th and 15th shlokas. If you see 14th and 15th shlokas in the third chapter, annad bhavanti bhutani parjanyad anna sambhavah, yajnyad bhavati parjanyah, yajnyah karma sabudbhavah. So there, yajnya is born out of karma. Karma is what? Karma is the sacrificial karma. Sacrifices prescribed in the deeds. Sacrificial deeds prescribed in the Vedas. So yajna is born of karma. So yajnat bhavati parjanya. Rain comes because of yajna. So here rain is given as an example. But all desires we fulfill through some action. That is the idea. So visarga hai in that sense. That you not as an offering, but you offer something to gods. Okay. Then, so three questions have been answered by Sri Krishna. One is Brahma, another one is Adhyatma, another one is Karma. Now the next question is Adhibhuta. What is Adhibhuta and what is Adhidaiva? So he says in the next verse, Adhibhutam Ksharo Bhavaha Purushaschadhidaivatam Adhiyajnyohamevatra Dehe Deha Bhrutam Vara. Deha Bhrutam, a person who has identified oneself with the body, one who has a body of the embodied, Deha Bhrutam, of a person who has a body of the embodied, Vara, the best, Ksharah, perishable, Bhavah, existence, Adhibhutam, is Adhibhuta, Purushah, indweller, Adhidaivatam, is Adhidaivata, Cha, and Atra, here, Dehe in the body, Aham, I, Eva, indeed, Adiyajna, Adiyajna. So, what is Adhibhuta? That Ksharah Bhavah, that which is perishable, of people who, of living beings which have body, the best Ksharah Bhava, perishable existence is Adhibhuta. So the perishable thing is Adhibhuta. Vara means the best of the embodied. Deha Bhrutam Vara, best of the embodied. It is an appellation, it is a name for Sri Krishna. Arjuna. Arjuna is called by this name. Sri Krishna is calling Arjuna, he is saying, Deha Bhrutam Vara, means, oh, best among the embodied. Best among the embodied. So, best among living beings, that is the idea. Then he says, Adhibhutam, what is Adhibhutam? Ksharah Bhavah. That which has got a perishable existence, that is Adhibhuta. Though, it is dependent on Brahman. Without Brahman, it cannot exist. It is dependent on that intelligent self-conscious principle. But it is material. It has got birth. So it is perishable. It has got death also. So that is called Adhibhuta. Whichever has got the swabhava nature of getting perished, whichever can be destroyed is Adhibhuta. Okay. And Purushascha Adhidaivatam, the indweller, Brahman, which is there inside every being, that is Adhidaivata. That is Adhidaivata. And Adhiyajna, Adhiyajna is Atradehe Ahameva Adhiyajna. In the body, in this body, Adhiyajna means the presiding deity of any sacrifice. Presiding deity of any sacrifice. So in this body, I alone am the Adhiyajna, Sri Krishna says. That means God alone is Adhiyajna. Okay. So the questions, what is Adhiyajna? Atra Dehesmin, in this body. That was the question. In this body, where is Adhiyajna? And what is Adhibhutam Adhidaivam, etc. Now the final question remains. Niyatatma bhihi, prayana kale katham nyeyosi. So, how will a person who is self-controlled know you at the time of death, prayana kale? So, that is being answered in the next shloka. Antakale cha mameva smaran muktva kalervaram yah prayati samadbhavam yati nastyatra samshayah. Antakale cha mameva smaran muktva kalevaram yaf prayati samadbhavam yati nastyatra samshayaha. Cha, and this is connected to the previous verse. So, and antakale, at the time of death, mam, me, eva, only, smaran, remembering, kalevaram, body, muktva, muktva means becoming free. Here, leaving. Yaha, who, prayati, goes forward, saha, that person, madbhavam, my being, yati, attains, atra, here, samshayaha, doubt, na, not, asti, is. So, one who, at the time of death, meditating on me, only meditating on me, mameva, only on me alone, goes forward means leaves the body, leaves one's identification with the body, that person attains me, madbhavam yati, attains me means that person comes to me, means that person becomes free of this repeated birth and death. A person who at the end of one's life thinks of me. Me means the ultimate reality. Ultimate reality. Call it Brahman, call it the God. Ultimate reality. A person who thinks, that person attains me, comes to me. There is no doubt about this. There is no doubt about this. The next shloka we'll see tomorrow. Om Shanti 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 Hari Om Tat Sat.